Upfront Books presents Negative Self-Talk and How to Change It, written by Shad Helmstetter, Ph.D., and narrated by Douglas Martin. If you want to accelerate the positive shift in your mindset and most effectively put the book's concepts into action, check out selftalkplus.com. There you'll find an app with positive self-talk audio sessions designed to erase and replace your past mental programs with healthy, new ones. Feel free to pause the audiobook now and get the app by visiting selftalkplus.com. A personal note from the author. In this book, I have brought together the most important discoveries on the subject of negative self-talk and how to change it, and its profound effect on our individual lives. This book was designed for people who are busy. That means most of us. We take less time today to relax and listen and enjoy. We want to get right to the point, learn something useful, and move on. We want information we can use. In the following audio, that's what you'll find. Information that is up-to-date, highly useful, perhaps even life-changing, with a minimum of words to get the message across. As you will hear, because of how the brain gets wired, the key to retention is repetition. Please feel free to listen more than once to any information you want to keep forever. Chapter 1. The message of this book. There is no greater path you can walk, no greater goal you can achieve, and no greater purpose you can find than to live up to the promise you were born to fulfill. The purpose of this book is to give you all of the basics you should know about negative self-talk and how to change it. I will begin with 12 key points that summarize this concept. 1. All of us were programmed from birth on, and we end up living out the programs we received. 2. From the moment you were born, everything you heard, everything you thought, and everything you said out loud or to yourself was temporarily recorded in your brain. 3. The messages you received that were repeated frequently were physically and chemically wired into your brain. We refer to those repeated messages as programs. The more often those programs were repeated, the stronger they were wired into your brain. 4. It is estimated that during the first 18 years of your life, if you grew up in a reasonably positive home, as much as 77% of the programs you received were negative. Whatever those programs were, many of them are still with you today. 5. The part of the brain that stores the programs you received doesn't know the difference between something that is true and something that is false. The brain is designed to act on the strongest programs it receives as though they are true, whether they're true or not. 6. As much as 90% or more of your programs are unconscious and are completely hidden from you. 7. Along with your genes and your experiences, you are the result of the programs you received. 8. Everything you believe, everything you think, everything you say, and everything you do is the result of the programs you received, both from others and from yourself. 9. Your self-talk, right now, is a replay of the programs you have that are the strongest. 10. Negative self-talk is the combined result of the negative programs you received from others and those you gave to yourself. Most of them are unconscious. 11. Because of its neuroplasticity, your brain is designed to continually rewire itself throughout your lifetime. 12. If you have programs that are negative and working against you, you can change them. You can rewire them. Replace them with different, more positive, and more successful programs. That is the message of this book. Chapter 2. Negative Self-Talk. Negative self-talk is everywhere. We are in the middle of an epidemic of it, and it is getting worse. Negative self-talk is so widespread that I have even given it a name, negative self-talk disorder, which I will cover in Chapter 4. Negative self-talk is anything you think or say that looks at something from a perspective of what won't work instead of what can work. Anything you think or say that overfocuses on your fears instead of on your strengths. Anything you think or say about yourself that repeatedly focuses on faults or flaws instead of positive qualities. Anything you think or say that causes you to see your world as filled with problems instead of opportunities and positive choices. Anything you think or say that limits you from being or achieving anything that is real and possible. And finally, anything you think or say that limits your belief in yourself or your future. What does negative self-talk sound like? Whether you say it out loud or think it silently to yourself, it's easy to spot negative self-talk. Here are a few examples of what negative self-talk sounds like. Nothing ever goes right for me. I just know it won't work. It's going to be one of those days. Why even try? The only luck I ever have is bad luck. I just can't do this. I'm so clumsy. I'm so stupid. I can never remember names. This just isn't one of my days. Everything I eat goes right to my waist. I can never get ahead. I'm no good at math. Life sucks. Negative self-talk might also sound like, I never know what to do. I'm at my wit's end. That's easy for you to say. My kids are driving me crazy. If only I were smarter, taller, and richer. I can't handle this. It's just no use. I don't have the talent. I'm just not creative. I just wasn't cut out for that. I never have enough money left over at the end of the month. I can never seem to get organized. I already know I won't like it. And perhaps you've said some of these. I never have enough time. I just don't have the patience for that. I'm too shy. I never know what to say. I don't have the energy I used to. I never win anything. Nobody likes me. Everything I touch turns sour. I just can't seem to get anything done. Now that's impossible. There's just no way. I never get a break. Today just isn't my day. And on and on and on. Each time you repeat phrases like those, you are literally wiring your brain to believe that what you're saying is true about you. Negative self-talk sets you up to fail. Notice that in the examples of negative self-talk just given, in each case, the self-talk predicts failure. Negative self-talk is almost always self-defeating. It sets you up for failure. It anticipates failure. It expects failure, like it's a sure thing. So when you practice negative self-talk...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.